survey says it's 6 o'clock, time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
Feud with two families are going to have a lot of fun tonight as they play for $10,000, and all they have to do is guess what 100 random people wrote on a simple little survey. How easy is that? Ready to meet them now? First up, welcome back our champs from Victoria, the Beattie family. Great to see you guys back. Who have you brought with you?
My daughter Alex, my niece Caitlin, and my sister Kathy.
Lovely, and ready to take them on tonight from Queensland, the Albers family. Who have you wrangled for this occasion?
My beautiful sister Angela, my son Sam, and my daughter Hannah.
Lovely to meet you guys. Team captains, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. What's an everyday task you would have trouble doing with a broken arm? Lynn?
Getting dressed.
Getting dressed could be difficult. Nice.
Hi.
Lovely to see you.
You too.
Great to have you with us.
Thank you.
You've got this unique skill of being able to count carbs quickly.
I can, very quickly.
Like what situations, like a loaf of bread?
Well, 2 slices would be 30 in general, average.
Where did you acquire this skill?
Well, my little girl is 6 now, and when she was 4, she was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, so everything she eats, you have to count the carbs exactly to give her the insulin balance for the carbs.
Sort of a life necessity for you now.
Everything, yeah.
And you're an advocate for diabetes?
Yeah, very much so. I have an online diabetes business and try and raise awareness and raise funds for a cure. So everything we can for our little girl to just try and find a cure for type 1.
Let's hear it for Angela, everyone. Keep up the good fight.
Thank you.
What's an everyday task you would have trouble doing with a broken arm?
Definitely showering.
Let's try it. How are you, Sam?
Good.
An everyday task you would have trouble doing with a broken arm?
Eating breakfast.
Yeah. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Look, how?
How?
Yeah.
Woo!
Well...
Couldn't you just use your other arm?
You could, but it depends what you're eating. You could be eating a BLT, I don't know.
You're saying something that might require 2 hands.
Yeah, exactly.
Breakfast. First try. Oh. You gotta try, man. You gotta try. Hi, Hannah. How are you?
Hi, I'm good.
Lovely to have you with us. You freak out. At what?
My neck being touched.
Your what?
My neck being touched.
Your neck. You can't have anybody at all, under any circumstances, touch your neck.
No, sometimes it's like all right, and then other times I'll drop to the floor or I'll hit you.
Really? Should we test it out? I so want to do it.
Do it!
I'm going to save it and I'm going to spring it on you when you don't know. You're going to be in fear all night. What's an everyday task you would have trouble doing with a broken arm, Hannah?
Making meals.
Making meals. Yeah. High five. Show's not over yet, Hannah.
It's not comforting.
Oh, we laugh, Lynn. Don't we laugh?
Oh, she's a treasure.
She sure is a treasure. That's what we always say. Hannah's a treasure.
She's special.
What's an everyday task you would have trouble doing with a broken arm?
Tying your shoelaces?
Yep. Yeah. Oh! Second strike. Beattie family, get set for a steal. Ooh. Angela, it's up to you.
Oh, I was going to say housework.
Yeah. Could be difficult. Yeah. Is it there? Yeah. Got something, Sam?
Driving.
Yeah. Is that driving? What about driving on the board? Yeah. Yeah.
Why are you gonna be like this?
Just doing my hair, Hannah. Just doing my hair. What's an everyday task you'd have trouble doing with a broken arm?
I'm gonna go with work. Like,
just work.
You might need both arms.
Let's give it a shot. Third strike. Beattie's. Kath.
Washing your hair.
Caitlin.
That's what I said, washing.
Alex.
Typing.
Marie. A couple of great options. Yours to choose, though.
I think I'll go with washing your hair.
Washing your hair, say the Beatties. Points goes to the Albers. Number four. Brushing your teeth. So simple, but so real. 52 is the points that the Alberts pick up at the start of the game, and if either family goes on to win for 5 nights in a row, they'll be driving home in a brand-new Mitsubishi Outlander. The Outlander seats 5 with features including Mitsubishi's multi-communication system, dusk-sensing headlamps and CVT auto with paddle shift. For everyone playing along at home who want the top answer to this one, name an iconic landmark in Australia. Let's come back and compare answers in just a second. A lot of fun. We certainly are tonight. Now, before the break, I asked, name an iconic landmark in Australia. The top answer was...
Orange!
Could have been a couple of options, so well done if you got it. Give me Alex, give me Angela. Let's go. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name somewhere specific you might find graffiti. Angela.
Street wall.
On a street wall. Can you beat it, Alex?
Alleyway.
In an alleyway. All right, you got it, Angela. Pass it. Okay, you got the next one. Somewhere specific you might find graffiti.
A train.
On a train's good. Let's try that. Yeah. Boom. Yeah. You look like a graffiti artist, Kathy. You were under the cover of darkness going through and artistically decorating the town.
Are you waiting for an answer?
You don't believe the story? I was building up a wonderful backstory for you, Kath. Name somewhere specific you might find graffiti.
A toilet block.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good try. How about you, Marie?
Similar to train, but I'm going to say train station.
Let's give it a shot. Yes. Somewhere specific you might find graffiti.
A fence.
On a fence. Yes. First strike. Caitlin?
A school.
You might see it around school. The Alberts family can steal, so they're going to try and coordinate a huddle over there. Although they seem to just bump into one another. Okay, name somewhere specific you might find graffiti.
A road.
You might find it on a road. That's 3 strikes. Alberts. Hannah.
Skate park.
Skate park, cool. Yeah.
Skate park.
Angela.
Back of a toilet door. Not myself.
Oh, but... yeah, sure.
Not with well... for a good time written there. I hope not, Angela. Lynn.
With her 3 kids, I'd say the toilet door, but I think I'm going for the skate park.
You reckon skate park? It's where the little ghetto kids hang out. Yeah. Is skate park there? Barnstorming performance tonight. Number 7. It takes the Alberts to 144, a cracking night so far for them. Look, you know you love watching Family Feuds, and why not play along at home with the official Family Feud game? Simply head to 10play, check out Family Feud for all the details and the fun that goes on behind the scenes as well. After the break, it's double points on the next question, which means both families are still in the game on the Feud. Family likely to reach 300 points in this round will get a shot at $10,000. Right, the scores are the Beattie family, our carryover champs, are sitting on zero right now. That's because the Alberts keep stealing all the points on 144. But remember, double points time now for this next question, which means both families are right in this game. So give me Caitlin, give me Sam, let's play. We surveyed 100 people and the top five answers are on the board. Name something that you would find in a gym. Sam.
Weights.
Weights. Yeah. Top answer. Something that you would find in a gym, Hannah.
I've never been to a gym, but I'm going to say mirrors.
Yeah. So you're saying that people like to watch themselves as they're...
Well, people take lots of photos at the gym.
That's true, don't they?
It's like you can't go to a gym without saying
I'm working out. 1,001, 1,002. Let's have a look. Oh! You ain't working out unless someone's seeing it. Lynn.
I'd say there would be people there. So,
makes
people.
Sense. Yeah. Oh! Two strikes pressure. The Beattie family Seriously. Could steal. Angela.
I was going to say...
You're getting a little testy there, Lynn. Oh, seriously?
Seriously.
It's harder
Mine
when you're
Mine were the
here.
Sixth and seventh and eighth answer.
Do you think so?
Yes, it wasn't top five.
Angela.
I was thinking treadmills.
Yeah! Seems to be quite popular in the room. Let's give it a shot. Yep. A 40-hour gaming session, as in like yes. PlayStation gaming sessions?
Xbox, yes.
Xbox. 40 hours straight?
Yes. Well, 40 hours with maybe an hour or two break in between.
Oh.
Like toilet breaks, food, that's about it.
Wow. So it's like you would have had like hand lock like this for like a week afterwards, wouldn't you? Gamer's hand.
Not really, but close to it.
Wow. Was it just you were always planning to do 40 hours or just yeah, ended up yeah. being 40 hours?
Yeah, we sort of planned 40 hours. We've actually decided that we're going to try and do 50 hours.
So, hey, why not 60? 70?
70.
Let's
80.
Let's just
let's
do
go 100.
All right. Something that you would find in a gym.
I'm just going to go trainers.
Yeah, cool. Something that you would find in a gym, Hannah.
Once again, I've never been, but I'm gonna go with the like equipment side of things and like the bike one. Yeah. Yeah. Bikes, yeah.
Exercise bike?
Yeah, those things.
Let's give it a shot. Yeah! One left on the board, Albert's family. What's number five, Lynn? This is going so good for you guys. Mm. Awesome lineup.
Oh, no. I'm gonna let them down.
Two strikes though, so you need to make this one count.
Try a sauna.
Something that you would find in a gym. They often have saunas because it helps you lose weight, doesn't it? And it cleanses the body, detoxes, makes you feel good.
Please.
Is number five sauna. It's over to the Beattie family. Kat.
A bench press.
Caitlin.
Maybe a pool.
Alex.
Yoga mats.
Marie. They've done all the work over there. You could just steal all of that and call it your own. You just need one answer. What's number five?
I'm going to go with pool.
Pool?
Pool.
Pool it is. It's pool on the board. Taking home $1,200 and plus we're going to give you guys a $1,000 gift card to share between you courtesy of Proud's the Jewelers where you'll find great gift ideas for the whole family and you'll also be taking home our brand new Family Feud game. So, the Beattie family, great try, guys. Albert, who's playing Fast Money? Angela is. Hannah is.
Well, that's us.
Come on in, guys. Come on in. Come on in.
What? I wasn't doing anything. Stop acting like I'm creepy. You're the one who can't have anyone touch your neck. You head back to your soundproof booth. And you and I, let's just high five. We'll play for $10,000 next in a segment we call Fast Money right here on The Feud with that new chance.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Welcome back. It's Fast Money time here on The Feud. So let's see if the Alberts can now win some cash. And they've been playing beautifully. It was not even really a close race in the end. I think you won by more than a neck anyway.
That's not bad.
If you missed it before the break, poor old Hannah here can't have anybody touch her neck. She has kind of like a major, major freak out about it. So we've joked about it tonight, but I'm going to leave her be right now because this is a serious part. She needs to concentrate. If you and Angela get 200 points or more between you, you'll win $10,000, OK? Angela is now in our soundproof booth and can't hear your answers. Clearly you think she dances funny. I'm going to ask you 5 questions and I'll give you 20 seconds to answer, okay? Now, if you pass, we'll come back at this time and the clock starts at the end of the first question.
Okay.
You set?
Yep.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, Hannah.
Yep.
Fill in the blank. It's hard to find a good...
man.
Name something that gives off heat.
Fire.
Name something that has a hood.
A jacket.
Name a reason why your nose might turn red.
Cold.
Name something crunchy.
Cornflakes.
That in?
Hopefully.
No, it looked like you did it easy. What, did it feel that way?
I was a bit worried, but I don't know. I just kind of just said.
That's what you got to do. Just let it fall out of your mouth. Fill in the blank. It's hard to find a good, you said, man. Survey says. Yeah. Nuts. Name something that gives off heat, you said. Fire does. Survey says. Something that has a hood, you said. Jacket. Survey says. 22. You're right on the money. Name a reason why your nose might turn red, you said. Cold. Survey says. That's pretty good. You're over the 100 mark with one still to go. Name something crunchy, you said. Cornflakes are crunchy. Survey says. Great. Oh. Hannah, magnificent. Well, Hannah, head back to the family. Do the ball. Welcome back, Angela.
Thank you.
Oh, the old funny sticks over there, Hannah, did all right. You only need 82 points to get $10,000. So she's done her bit, now it's time for you to do yours.
Okay.
I'm going to ask you the same 5 questions, but as you're the second player, it's a little harder, so I'll give you an extra 5 seconds, okay?
Yep.
If you pass on a question, I'll ask it again if there's time, and if you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound, and I'll ask you to try again. Can we remind everybody of Hannah's answers? And 25 seconds on the clock too, please. The time starts from the end of the first question. Good luck.
Thank you.
Fill in the blank. It's hard to find a good...
husband.
Try again.
Teacher.
Name something that gives off heat.
Oven.
Name something that has a hood.
Jumper.
Name a reason why your nose might turn red.
Cold.
Try again.
Embarrassed.
Name something crunchy.
Carrot.
Excellent work. Sure, let's go. Right, here we go. Fill in the blank. It's hard to find a good, you said. Teacher, survey says. Man was the top answer. Hannah had that. You could have said job. That was the second highest answer. What's a little awkward is the fact that you are married and you first said husband. Someone's in trouble.
And I love my daughter's teacher too. So.
Wow. You're really in trouble.
Yeah.
Something that gives off heat. You said. Oven. Survey says. Heater was the top answer. So we need 78 points for $10,000. Name something that has a hood. You said. Jumper. I like it. And so should you. Because it's the top answer.
not like it.
This lot over here.
Now we only need 30 from these last two to get $10,000. Name a reason why your nose might turn red. You said.
Embarrassed.
You're embarrassed.
Tried to cheat, but.
Survey says. That's embarrassing. cold was the top answer. Hannah had that. So we need 30 now from this last answer. We can do it. We're going to try. Name something crunchy. You said. Carrots. Do you feel confident about that as an answer?
Oh,
would 100 Australians say carrots?
Hopefully 31,
because that's all we need. Then you've got $10,000. You ready?
Yes.
All we can do is try. Survey says. Oh! Did you about to celebrate? Did you think you got that? Chips was the top answer.
Thanks for watching. I'm Grant Daniel. Good night, Australia.